Hello, Primer Magazine. For this month, we are looking at the dress down suit or a full suit worn casually, which for me, if done right or when done right, it is one of the most elegant, practical, and relaxed way to wear a suit. It is perfect for date night, going to the bar, going to the club, anything like that. For weddings, it is also an incredible and very beautiful step up from jeans for casual Friday at the office. The very first thing I want to talk about is the fit of the suit, which is to me the most important part to nail down when wearing a suit casually. What we want from the very first stop here, we want to see clean lines. The shoulders, we want soft shoulders, not hard shoulders like you would find maybe on a business double-breasted suit or just a winter tweed jacket. We're looking at very, very soft shoulders that will follow the natural slope of your shoulder and also make it look a bit more like just a regular jacket, just like a bomber jacket would have. The second thing I want to point out is the length of the sleeves. It's very important that those are also tailored to you and they're not too long, because again, as you're wearing this casually, it's very important that the fit is nailed. When you're looking at the pants, you want tailored pants with hands just right above the shoes, absolutely no break. This will help with the shoe choices, and we'll talk about the shoe choices a little bit later during this screencast. The second thing I want to talk about is the fabric itself, because first of all, if the fit is nailed, you can actually afford to be very adventurous with the fabric. But again, then we might be venturing into more expensive suits, because then perhaps you'd have to get that custom made or get it from more expensive brands. But once the fit is nailed down, the fabrics, I highly recommend casual fabrics. So we're talking about linen, cotton suits, even some very light wools in the winters can work, but those are a little bit more tougher to find. So we're gonna stay focused on the summer here. When it comes to the shirts to wear under the suit itself, I'm a huge fan of t-shirts. So for this particular outfit, I'm wearing a striped t-shirt that I got from Gap about 3 or 4 years ago. It's just a classic blue striped shirt. It's incredible. It's incredibly elegant, and I've worn it many, many times. But you could also swap it for a polo, a knit polo, a Henley, a turtleneck in the winters, or a button-down shirt as well. All of those items could work just perfectly for the dress down suits. The suit itself is a suit that I've had for about 6 years, and I got it from H&M, believe it or not, and I've gotten plenty of wear out of it and a ton of compliments as well. And that's also, I think, part of why it fits so naturally and just kind of embraces the shape of my body. Let's talk about the fit itself, how to wear the suit jacket. I believe that when you're wearing a suit casually, it's very important to skip some of the details you would wear on a business suit, like the pocket square, for example. I'll go ahead and skip that generally, just so it doesn't feel too serious, because I'm trying to bring down the formality of the suit. The second thing I want to point out is the hands in the pockets and utilizing the pockets. This is an important PSA. Guys, please use your pockets. Utilizing the pockets on your jacket will bring the stiffness of the suit like 5 notches down. A lot of guys actually go around with suits where the pockets are still sewn shut, and they believe that they're fake pockets, but all they need to do is remove the small thread. For the adventurous ones, one thing that they could experiment with would be popping your collar, because again, a reminder that once the suit is worn casually, the suit jacket automatically just turned into a regular jacket. So just as you would pop the collar on a trucker jacket and it not feel so stiff or not make it feel easy, you could do the same with a suit jacket. But the trick is to pop the back of the lapel up and then laying the rest of the lapel down. So it's kind of like a half up, half down style. That's really casual and very cool. the glasses, I choose to go for some classic Ray-Ban Wayfarers, which are some of the coolest glasses you could possibly wear, I believe, and also the most classic. It will make you look really, really cool at a pool party on the pool side. When it comes to the accessories, the belt is very important to pick a belt that is casual. I went with a double looped belt from J.Crew. This is, the fabric is leather, but the buckle is very casual, which again is very important. I could have also gone for maybe a nautical belt or a braided belt, for example. Any belt that's very casual would work out really nicely with this outfit. Another very important detail in bringing the casualness of the suit down would be, if available, utilizing the functional buttons on your jacket. Given this suit is from H&M, I was pleasantly surprised that they actually included functioning buttons. And so what I do if I have functioning buttons in a dress down suit, I will open the bottom button and then give the suit one fold up. And also the bracelets, I'll keep the bracelets. Maybe it helps with showcasing your bracelets. Folding the suit sleeve up a little bit will help with showcasing your accessories, like the bracelets or your watch if you're wearing one. The rings, I try to keep them to just always kind of like a minimum, maybe 2-3. I kind of go adventurous, but this is like a place where you could just play with what you have. But again, it's the summer and it's a casual outfit, so it's a nice time to showcase some of the things you've been collecting. When it comes to the pants, it's very important to go with no breaks at all in a casual outfit, I believe. And the reason for that is the shoes, you have a few selections from shoes. For me, I went with these 1953 horse bit loafers from Gucci that I scored on eBay for $150 just a couple of months back. But any loafers with no show socks or no socks at all would work with this outfit, whether it's tassel loafers, penny loafers, or any other type of loafers. The other thing that you could wear is sneakers as well, like grown-up sneakers, but those, they do wear up a little bit more, which is where the higher hemming comes into play. So as the shoe gets a little taller, you don't want your pants to start bunching up at the top. Last thing is just embracing the creases on the linen suits, not being afraid to showcase, because I believe they add to the coolness of the suit itself. So guys, embrace it. With that, this would be the end of the screencast. For any questions, feel free to ask them via email. I appreciate you guys. Bye.